Hoo-hoo, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Ninja Hen vs. Copycat. You're currently looking at my spreadsheet, and today I want to show you how this spreadsheet works. Here you see the comparison of the first chapters I did in the video for Wordstock. Please check out this video if you're interested in these novels and their first chapter. And today I will add another chapter of Starship Troopers. The Ninja Hen vs. Copycat project is about copying classics, and the classic I copy at the moment is Starship Troopers by Robert A. Heinlein. This is the first chapter. Because it was so long, I had to divide it in two parts. The second chapter is long as well. We just try it if it works without dividing it. All right. So this is the chapter. I copied it. Now I'll insert it in the cell. Yeah. I know what this sound means. This sound means, you can't do this. But I haven't found out why this sound comes now and then. Let's try first to enter the chapter in a neutral document and then copy it again. Nope. We try copying roughly the half of it. Yeah. It seems it was too long again. I now entered a title for the sheet. And now I press Create Worksheet from Text. This may take a while, the program isn't very fast. Good, let's look it over. Here, this should be two sentences. Alright, I found the problem. It seems that Word is substituting the ellipsis with one special sign, one special ellipsis sign. I mean, that's kind of ridiculous. So I've got the option to replace it here in my text document, or I change the programming. I think I will change the programming. So I fixed it and ran it again, and now this issue seems fine. But I have to say to you, nearly in all chapters I posted, there is a different issue that popped up. There are so many things, how you can format sentences, how you can express sentences. I can't program for everything, so you have to go over it manually. Like, this here is a common error as well, but one I don't know how to fix. It's if you have abbreviations with a period, program believes that it is a new sentence. So I delete them manually. Okay, the rest looks pretty good. Then we analyze it. This runs even longer. The first button created a worksheet, entered the sentences and the length of the sentences, analyze, enters the sentence starter, the type and the word count, filter words and undesirables. The type is basically, is it normal text, is it dialogue, is it a dialogue tag? And things I have to judge manually, whether it's a dialogue tag or not, or an action tag. Sentence starters. Here's a list with different sentence starters. And here are the categories for the sentence lengths. to assess whether it's a regular sentence, I've got a list. These lists are common names in the novel. It's just that I know, okay, if the sentence starts with Johnny or Harry or Hagrid, I know, okay, it's a pretty normal sentence. The second list is for conversation stuff. It's to analyze the sentence starter as well. So if you got kind of oomph, or maybe a yes, no, sorry, then it's just a sentence that appears if you say something, a sentence in dialogues. The third list is for assessing whether it's a dialogue tag or not. So these are common dialogue tags. The fourth list, now it gets interesting. It's for filter words. Please watch another video what filter words are. I'm a bit on the fence about them, and that's the reason why I look for them. I want to know if they're really as bad as some people think. The last list is for undesirables. These are words that you should use only very sparingly, or sparingly in some contexts. Like suddenly could be a filter word as well. I believe you never should use very. You should substitute words like very with a more fitting verb. The same goes for slightly. And just can be, it can be totally alright to use just, but sometimes it's just a filler. So I want to have it in the list that I can look at it and look at the usage of the word just. To the undesirables, I momentarily add all ly words. So these two, and of course these and this, are double because they're ly words, so they get caught in my algorithm even if I wouldn't have wrote them there. But maybe I divide the function in future in ly words and undesirables, so I let them stand there. It's just a few milliseconds more in program runtime, so that doesn't bother me. These two lists, filter words and undesirables, are here with the count. The last feature is to create the stats. So you have to focus where the stats should appear and then hit the button. The formatting and the features are copied from the first book. So I delete the colors. So we've got a pretty high amount of dialogue here as well. We have to look at the manual analysis. Let's do this first. That's a dialogue tag. I answered carefully as well. I added, said, create, maybe, maybe not. Another adding. I will improve this function. At the moment it only recognizes the dialogue text if they're in the first or the last position of the sentence, but I have all the information I need to recognize it during the sentence as well, so I can add this function soon. This time we have shorter sentences. Thank God, because the first chapter was amazing. He went overboard with the long sentences. We have a lot of connector words and a lot of question and prompts, but that's only natural with this many dialogue. Here we've got a high amount as well. What's that? Rest, yeah. We can look at the rest, maybe we can add some more names to it, then more sentences will be acknowledged as regular sentences. Yankee Doodle. Could we add Yankee? No, I don't think so. Carmen, okay. List. I think that was it. Well could be a dialogue thing, but he used well not in dialogue. So let's look first whether it's on the dialogue list. Yes, it is. Maybe I should... No. Well. Good, so now we are looking at the filter words. And we are not interested in a dialogue. Oh wow, I think that's alright, isn't it? I must have looked stunned. I must have... No, I believe that should be alright too. Seem to have different ideas about it. Instead, I simply told him that my father and I had different ideas about it. In this sentence, I don't think that there is additional value in seemed. Maybe it's with the word seemed, it's an emphasizes that it's from the perspective of our narrator, so he don't project into him that he's trying to find out what they have learned, but he is more objective about it, that it seemed to him that the teacher tried to find out what they have learned. Oh, this is okay, but this is really complicated stuff. I mean, I am a beginner in this whole filter word topic, and it's really difficult for me to judge whether it's all right or not all right. I knew her pretty well. Yeah, that's all right. Okay. All right, too. The next, she saw us and waited, dimpling. So everything seems okay for me. I believe I only found one sentence where I would substitute it. Oh, well. Next, the undesirables. I noticed a lot of L-Y words. Okay, we've still got the dialogue excluded. So we've got a really here. I never really intended to join up. You have to know the context for this, and I believe in this context is the really okay, because he kind of went with it, but he didn't really intended to join up, you know? Next, certainly not the infantry. Of course, most of them just think about it, toy with the idea a little, then go to something else, go to college or get a job or something. Let's skip this. I have no idea. It seems fine to me as well. I mean, sometimes you really have to emphasize things and not just glance over them. It's the first completely free choice. It's the first free choice. Okay, finally we've got the standard example for how to not use Lee words. He smiled grimly. She said shrilly. She answered very seriously. Oh, I could have betted that there were so many more. Mr. Dubois looked at her bleakly. I added brilliantly. I answered carefully. He said scornfully. I mean, this is really the standard case for not using them, but I personally believe that it's not bad. I mean, the book is an absolute classic. I keep an eye on it, if it's a thing with Heinlein or if it's just the second chapter. I mean, he went overboard. He totally went overboard. But it's so easy to use them. It's just so easy. You don't have to describe things, how firm his voice was or stuff like this. I mean, he added it firmly. Yeah, alright. You see, I've got my problems with it, but now I've got a tool to keep an eye on it, and that's the first step in every journey to solve problems, is first to monitor it. Yeah, we can see it at the moment with the coronavirus as well. The worst thing is that there are not enough tests in the United States at the moment. I believe in Germany the testing is alright, but I'm sure they've got their shortages as well. So I've got now a test. I can identify the undesirable words and I just analyze it. I analyze my text, and if I find ways to formulate the sentence more elegantly, then I will do this, of course. So these are the functions of my spreadsheet. If you want to try the spreadsheet yourself, I don't know if it works for the non-German version of Excel, but I would love to try it out, because the formulas have different names in German. I mean, the actual programming is the same, so there will be no problems. And if you're a bit familiar with Excel, you can replace the formulas. So if you want to try it out, I would be thankful, and I'm very excited to know whether it works in other language editions of Excel as well. So contact me. You can contact me over my homepage, or YouTube has my email address as well, and I'll send you the Excel. If you get Excels by people who are not as trustworthy as me, please be careful. You have to activate macros for it, and you can do very evil things with macros. Of course, I don't do evil things with macros, and I have everything open. So you can look at the whole coding and see for yourself that there is no evil stuff going on, right? Okay. And of course, adjust the coding to your needs. Good. So I won't say anything about the second chapter of Starship Troopers, because I believe it would be going overboard to go over every chapter separately. I will do a longer analysis with a few chapters at once, so we can compare the different chapters with each other as well. I believe that would be more interesting than spending time on every chapter. If you've got any question to my spreadsheet or any suggestions for more analysis features, please be free to use the comments. And bye bye.